Thank you. That first number was Spartan Swing, which we debuted at our winter concert. It was actually written by Jack Buckley on piano. And it's been along with district social media. He did enter it in the National Jazz Festival under student compositions, and Jack's piece, Spartan Swing, did win first place. So it's been wonderful. And part of winning that, Jack's piece was recorded by the University of North Texas 1 o'clock Band, which is one of the top jazz programs in the country. So that was, when you listen to it, if you find it on, it's on Facebook, it's on everything, but that is them playing his recording. So we've had a busy last month between having state finals on April 30th to the musical. So I opened it up to the students and I asked the seniors to pick a piece or two that we've played throughout their time here that they wanted to play one more time. So that's what these next two selections are. I think they were the only two options that were thrown out with great enthusiasm. But that first one is Brass Machine by Mark Taylor, and we will be featuring the entire trumpet section. Mark Ray is on trumpet, Anthony Vicatorio on the drum set, and Owen D'Elia on trumpet.
Thank you.
The next one we wanted to do again is Feeling Good, and it will be featuring senior vocalist Sean Adderholm. Especially if they haven't as much, and both Ethan Cottle on trombone and Chris Filburn on alto sax wanted to take this opportunity. So Africa featuring Ethan Cottle and Chris Filburn. point out a couple of the accomplishments of the band this year. It was a quick year, and competitions were a little bit harder to find. However, when we found them, we had some great success. First one we attended this year was State Prelims, hosted here at Steinert. We had a student, Patrick Bagatoro, on bass, who was recognized as an outstanding soloist on that evening. So, the next one we attended was Jackson Liberty, and our outstanding musicians from the band that night were Anthony and Patrick Bagatoro on bass and drums, respectively. We had Luke O'Neill on tenor sax, who was recognized as an outstanding musician on the evening as well. The rhythm section won best rhythm section on the night. And the jazz band was selected the highest scoring jazz band, so the number one performance on the entire evening. We also, like I said, attended the National Jazz Festival, where we came in with an honorable mention in fourth place. So it was all virtual this year, but bands from around the world sent in tapes, and we came in fourth place in that one. And our final one was state finals on April 30th. We came in fifth in the state, but our rhythm section won best rhythm section award again, so this is the best rhythm section in the state of New Jersey. And one of the reasons we came home with that and Patrick won his solo was the chicken, and it's one that I don't think they're gonna let me not play. So for the final time this year, we have the chicken featuring Patrick Bagatoro on bass, Anthony Bagatoro on drum set, Luke O'Neill on tenor sax, Mark Reyes on trumpet, and Jack Buckley on piano. Thank you.
Thank you. tribute to the heroes of World War II. This piece allowed the audience as well as the performers to experience the intensity of the attack that occurred on Normandy beaches in June of 1944. It's interesting to note that the composer of this piece, Tyler Grant, was only 13 years old when this work was first commissioned and performed in 2009. So please enjoy Along the Beaches of Normandy.
Thank you.
based on the hymn, Go With My Soul, from 1876. It was written by a Chicago Presbyterian layman, Horatius Baffert, after his family was lost when their ship sank while sailing into Europe. It was written for wind band by Jim Wilson in 1989.
Thank you.
It was considered the guiding spirit of the Dixie Band, and Mr. Barbarotto has been involved in the band for over 60 years. The fanfare of this piece was written to capture his boundless enthusiasm and drive of his contributions to the world of music.
Thank you.
Explaining that it was his art and not he personally that was important. Aida tells the story of a love triangle in ancient Egypt. Rhadames, a captain of the Egyptian guard, is secretly in love with Aida, daughter of the king of Ethiopia and a slave at the Egyptian court. She returns his love, but he is also beloved by Amneris, the powerful daughter of the king of Egypt. Tricked into revealing military secrets, Rhadames is condemned to be buried alive. Opera. Aida joins him in a tomb beneath the temple, so sad, resolved to die with him. As they sing their final aria bidding farewell to earth, Amneris mourns and prays in the temple above. So it's not a happy opera, very sad. But this march is from scene two of the second act, and it presents the fanfare and splendor of the victorious army headed by Rhadames as it passes in review before the pharaoh. You may sometimes hear the grand march presented at things like graduations, or it was played at the Winter Olympics in Beijing when all of the athletes were entering the stadium. It was one of the pieces of music performed to bring the athletes in to kick off the games. So I'd like to take a moment to thank you all for coming and bringing the warmness in here. So we hope you've enjoyed our concert this evening, and please enjoy our final selection, the Grand March from Aida.
Thank you.
thank you again for coming. Please get home safe, and we hope to see you again at our concerts next year. Have a wonderful summer. Thank you all very much.